I want to get some of your thoughts on near term, midterm, and long term. What are you seeing in terms of Bitcoin in the near term, especially considering we have the halving in April?
I think everybody's targets for the halving, I would say something in the 90,000 to 100,000 by the halving, which is only a month away, by the way. You know, that's sort of, I think, what most people are hoping for at this point. So that's the near term, right? The next sort of period that people are looking for is the cycle, right? So Bitcoin tends to work in four-year cycles. There's a halving cycle. So the next halving is in 2028. So then there's a lot of people coming out with estimates for where are we going to be by the end of 2028, the mid-2028. And there, I would say, estimates are from, and these are just estimates, of course, but anywhere from 200,000 to, it could be as high as 500,000 to even a million by the end of 2028. And then the final target, I would sort of say, is what Bitcoiners call hyper-Bitcoinization, right? Which is sort of the, where do we finally end up with this? And that might be 20, 30 years out in the future. And a number that people throw around there is $10 million or $20 million per Bitcoin. So sounds crazy. I understand if we're talking about something that's trading at 70,000 now and saying it could possibly trade at 20 million sounds insane, but Bitcoin is insane. So nothing about Bitcoin is what matches a very steady, normal kind of thing. So it can go down more than you expect. It can go up way more than you expect as well.
We're going to pull up the charts that you posted showing Bitcoin as a power law. So break that down for us. Talk us through that.
This chart was discovered by an astrophysicist named Giovanni. And when you're looking at things in astrophysical time frames, you need to look at things that are very small and then things that are very big, like the distance of the size of the Milky Way. So you tend to look at things on a logarithmic scale. So if you look at that graph and you look at the price of Bitcoin in the logarithm of the price of Bitcoin, and you look at it in relationship to the logarithm of the time elapsed since the Genesis block, you will see that it's a straight, it sort of wobbles around a straight line from the very first year of Bitcoin to now. Because the straight line is in log space, that means that the actual price of Bitcoin is roughly time to the power six. Well, this is x to the power six, and that's roughly how much Bitcoin price goes up in time. Bitcoin has existed for 15 years now. Where will Bitcoin price be if the same pattern continues in another 15 years? Will it be double the current price? No. It'll be 2 to the power 6 the current price, which is 64 times as high as it is right now. So that's what a power law says, that if you double the amount of time, you get 2 to the power 6 higher in price. So 64 times higher in price. That seems crazy, but that's exactly the what Bitcoin has been doing over the last 15 years.
So in 15 years' time, Bitcoin at 70,000 times 64, I can't do the math in my head, but that's your price target?
Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, it's around four and a half million, roughly. The power law says you're going from 70,000 to 4.5 million in 15 years. Well, it's not totally crazy. The price of Amazon has gone up 100 times over the last, the price of Apple computer has gone up 100 times since they released the iPhone. That was one of my biggest mistakes, I think. I bought shares of Apple when they released the Apple iPhone. I sold them 3 years later at the price doubled. Now, had I held them, I would have made 50 times more money than I had by selling them 3 years later. So You tend to underestimate how much these things can go up, right? Nobody thought that Apple released the iPhone in 2007, right? Nobody thought that we'd be 100 times higher in price than they were in 2007. It's just insane. But yet, these technological advances can move, they can move 50, 100 times over 20 years. And I do think we're going to go 50 times higher in Bitcoin over the next 15, 20 years. It may go up a little bit more than that, but I do feel like that this opportunity right now over the next, let's call it next 5-10 years, is exceptionally good in Bitcoin. On a risk reward basis, the best it's ever been, because we've now got this ETF. It's all a question just of adoption now. The mechanism, everything is just ready to go. We don't have to invent new things. We don't have to invent new wallets or convince a Middle East nation or anything. We just have to get normal Wall Street people to go click on iBit in their and their Charles Schwab account. It's all there ready for them to buy. So we've never had it this easy, and the adoption can really happen right now at record speeds. And that's what we're seeing right now. And so it would not at all surprise me that the next year is just going to be a banger year for Bitcoin. Now, could we have some drops? Yeah, Bitcoin can drop 10% in a day. In my particular case, that's not a reason to not invest in Bitcoin. I think you want to be involved in Bitcoin, even though it can have 10%, 20% days. And because I think if you look over a couple of year period, it's going to do extremely well. But it's going to take, it takes some fortitude, and it's not for the faint of heart, right? Today's dollars, I would say $20 million a coin is kind of where we finally end up. Maybe in future dollars, it's $50 million. I don't know. The key thing is, I think we're getting to $1 million a coin, $1 million per Bitcoin.
A lot sooner than in 15 years, $1 million a Bitcoin. Well, what's the price projection for
power
that?
Power law says you will get there in 8 years. Right? If you just follow the curve, it says you'll get there in 8. If you believe that, that's enough, right? All you have to do is have 10%, 15% of your portfolio in Bitcoin. If you have 10%, 5% in your portfolio, maybe that 5%, 10% goes to 20% with the price appreciation. It's not a crazy risk. You want to get rich? Yeah, I do. I'm already rich, but like, I want to get richer. It's sort of like Michael Saylor said, this is a game, and whoever has the most Bitcoin wins the game. That's a zero-sum game. Whoever has the most wins.